Farage has acted. Now, it may seem swift in comparison to the dithering of Rishi Sunak, but it's hardly that fast. There's this disavowal of three candidates, Edward Oakenfull, Robert Lomas, and Leslie Lilley from Reform UK. And this underscores, I'm sure he hopes, the party's attempt to address offensive remarks made by these individuals. And these remarks are deeply offensive. You know, there's no question about how unpleasant this is. Edward Oakenfull, who's standing for the Derbyshire Dales, Robert Lomas for Barnsley North, Leslie Lilley for Southend East and Rochford. They will still appear on the ballot papers as Reform candidates, but it's too late because it's too late to have them removed. But he is distancing himself from them. Oakenfull talked about sub-Saharan IQ on social media last year, and he said that the comments have been taken out of context. I don't see how that's remotely possible. IQ is a validated mathematical register. I think it's ridiculous, but nevertheless, it's validated and measured. And to talk about sub-Saharan IQ in a dismissive way is prejudiced, racist, bigoted. Mr. Lomas said that black people should get off their lazy arses and stop acting like savages. This was reported on the 8th of June. And again, Reform said that this was out of context and part quotations. I don't see how such comments could ever be contextualized. They're just vile and vicious. And Lilley talked about people arriving in small boats as scum. He says, I hope your family get robbed, beaten, or attacked. I don't think, again, that these things can be contextualized. And yesterday, the Farage camp was saying that the Lilley story would be dealt with after the election. So there's been a change, which I suppose is to be applauded, but it only comes after the question time debate where Farage didn't do well. Let's face it, he was struggling with the barrage at the Farage of questions about his tolerance of racism and nastiness within the party. It's a tolerance that is routine. That's what he did in UKIP. He got away with it in UKIP. It's much harder to get away with it when he commands so much media attention. And there are people saying, well, he shouldn't command that much media attention. Don't give him so much of an opportunity. It's that opportunity and it's that media attention which has finally led to him recognizing this is wrong. I think that's a good thing. So despite being able to remove them from the ballot at this stage, Farage's public rejection of these people, partly during the BBC question time, partly afterwards, an hour ago the decision was formally made, it signals a fairly clear stance against that behaviour. But I don't think it's enough. I don't think it's enough to be blaming the vetting process. I don't think it's enough to claim that somebody was an actor. I don't think it's enough to push things to one side. In the end, the Reform UK party is identified and exposed as a party that has indulged and tolerated racism and gone out of its way to tolerate racism, at least until after the election. That's what Farage stands for. The toleration of bad behaviour. And if he's finally pushed into a corner where he has to throw a few people away. I mean, you notice one of the people who is there, who is not there in the list of those who are excluded, is the fellow who was talking about the degenerate flag. I don't think he's a candidate, but he should surely be publicly excoriated. That's not happening, is it? Because I think that person is a friend of Farage. It's rather like a friend of Dorothy, but with a slightly different understanding.